All right, coming to the stage is my man. Yo, he's most definitely from the old school. He's from L.A. by way of St. Louis. Give it up for my man, funny motherfucker, Rodney Winfield.
Fuck it, we got to do it real fast. I ain't got but 7 minutes. Fuck that, it take me 7 minutes to get my dick out. I know it, I just wanted to wake you up. But niggas is back making movies again like a motherfucker now. We making movies every motherfucking week, we make a movie now. White people thought we was gonna make Gone with the Wind our first motherfucking movie. That a bitch, if we kept doing it, we'd get it right. And now, because if white people made movies, they used to make themselves heroes, like Tarzan. One white motherfucker went to the jungle and took it over. Swing through the motherfucking trees and holler and shit. Wrestle with alligators. A nigga been living in the jungle all his life and couldn't say hello to a motherfucking monkey. That a bitch. And I don't know where they got niggas to play in the movies, too. They be going through the jungle with 2-bedroom apartments on their motherfucking head. Then they made a scary motherfucking movie, The Exorcist, about a little white bitch get attacked by the devil. It was supposed to be scary. They had to have a nurse in the show with white folk. They be passing out, oh, the devil. Niggas was in there eating popcorn. Get the devil, bitch. Go ahead, get the bitch. And this little white girl got possessed by the devil and she passed and she go, and spit on her mama and shit like that. That's why my sister couldn't have never got possessed by the devil, because soon she spit on my mama, that would have been it for her and the motherfucking devil both. Go home and spit on a black mama and see what happened to your ass. The devil be out on Broadway some motherfucking place. See, niggas never get possessed by the devil because we got too many problems already. Because I was, as soon as my mama would have walked in the house, my mama said, girl, what the fuck's wrong with you? Got all that green shit around your mouth. You been down there fucking with them Mexicans again, ain't you? You got guacamole all over the motherfucking house. I'm sorry, Mexican. I love y'all. You don't have to have no green card. I wouldn't give a fuck. I hope they bring 100,000 more of you motherfuckers over here, because somebody got to wash these cars and pick this fruit. And I ain't going to do a motherfucking thing, never in life. Because there's one thing I found out about work, it take a whole motherfucking day. Think I'm busy? I got a job. I'm looking for one. And then they made Superfly. I don't give a fuck what the black preachers say. Kiss my ass. I love Superfly. It was about a cool motherfucker. Snorted cocaine all day, kicked the police ass, had a custom Cadillac, and didn't go to the army. I love the motherfucker. If I was president, I'd make it a law where every motherfucker had to watch it once a week. But the only thing about that movie is it sent a lot of niggas to the penitentiary trying to do that shit for real. I didn't even know about cocaine till I saw the movie, but I'm glad I saw it. Now I'm snorting everything I can get my nose on. Salt, flour, baking powder. God gave me some pineapple coke last night, Massengill douching powder. My nose ran all night. I had to put a mini pad on the motherfucker. That girl going, You'd be mad if you didn't need one this month, wouldn't you? And this nigga with you'd be mad, too. Especially if he haven't fucked yet. But you know what? Nobody calls up ABC, NBC, and CBS and tell them to take Kotek commercials off of television. They're on television all day long. I can't even eat my dinner. I be eating a little greens and ham hocks, and I put a little vinegar on them, and the commercial come back on. We done put the vinegar back in the dish. Now, what nigga can eat lunch after that? Then they got another commercial where a lady be running in slow motion. She said, get a mini pad. You can swim in it. Comes in three different sizes. It's got a plastic strip on it. Then they got a lady with a great big ass turn. Makes me look like I ain't wearing nothing. That a bitch? I got a big TV too, an ass that fall out on the living room floor. I go up and feel the motherfucker. But one thing I want to say, you look beautiful tonight. God damn it, you look good, and we're glad of that because it's hard to do a show in front of a bunch of ugly motherfuckers. Normally, ugly people just pay extra money and rush their ugly ass right down front. But you look nice. I swear you do. But I also must admit there are a few ugly people sprinkled here and there around the room. And you ugly motherfuckers know who you are. And the guy sitting next to you know you're ugly, too. Look at everybody looking. No, you the ugly motherfucker. But don't mess with no ugly guy. He'll kick your ass because he's mad because he's ugly. They want to put a scar on your ass so you be ugly as they are. You never saw a nice-looking person start a fight. Always an ugly motherfucker. I think it ought to be a law against two ugly people fucking. You'll bring another ugly motherfucker in the world. And then they ain't got nothing to do, and then you got crime. If you don't believe me, carry your ass down to jail. Nothing down there but ugly motherfuckers. I was the nicest looking guy there. I'm out of here, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much.